Hi, in today's video, we'll be looking at the map questions, which are likely to appear in your academic IELTS writing task 1. In the map question type, you could be asked to describe one map in the present day, or describe two maps, one in the present and one in the future, or one in the past and one in the present. Out of these three main types, the third one, where you have to compare the map of the past to the one of the present, is the most common and will be the main focus of this video lesson. So you'll basically be looking at two maps of the same place, but one will be of the past and one of the present. You'll have to describe the main features and differences between the two maps. As we'll be talking about two different times, past and present, it becomes very important that you use proper tenses. To describe the map of the past, you'll be using the simple past tense, whereas to report the present day map, you'll be using present perfect tense. Why present perfect? Because even though the changes started in the past, they continue to the present day and they exist in the current time. Right? Make sense? Now let's discuss a sample map question. Let's look at the instructions first, which are always the same. You should spend about 20 minutes on this task and write at least 150 words. Now let's read out the statement. It says, the diagrams below show the changes that have taken place at Hotel Paramount from its year of construction 1990 to 2020. Summarize the information by selecting and reporting the main features and make comparisons where relevant. All right. The two maps here are of Hotel Paramount. One is of the year 1990 when the hotel was constructed, and the other is of the current year, that is 2020. Your task is to write a summary that describes the various changes that have taken place at the hotel from 1990 to 2020. Now, to describe the different changes, you will have to first analyze and identify all those changes, right? So the first step in writing a map summary would be analyzing and identifying the changes. Take a couple of minutes to observe the maps from the past up until the present day. Let's first make a list of all the changes that have taken place at Hotel Paramount. Number of houses has increased, which means the population has increased over all these years. Farmland has been reduced to half to make place for a restaurant. A huge patch of forest has been cleared to build a swimming pool and children's play area. Car parking space has also been increased. Also, the single lane road has been widened to a double lane one. There you go. These are the major changes at the hotel from 1992 to 2020. Now you have to elaborate on these points in your map summary. Once you have analyzed and identified the different changes between the two maps, you can start writing your response. To give a proper structure to your response, you can divide the content into four paragraphs: introduction, overview, body paragraph 1, and body paragraph 2. So this is the outline we are going to use to structure the map summary. Let's begin with introduction. Begin your map summary with an introduction, which is meant to introduce the topic to the examiner. You just need to tell what the maps show. For this, you can simply paraphrase the question statement in your own words using synonyms. For a sample question, the introduction could be something like, the two maps illustrate significant changes that have occurred at Hotel Paramount over a 30-year period from 1990 to 2020. The main features in the maps: farmland, forest, restaurant, swimming pool, and kids zone are presented using different colors. So you can see here, paraphrasing is done by replacing the words diagrams with maps, show with illustrate, and taken place with occurred. The adjective significant has been added before the noun changes because we do see a lot of changes. Besides this, the phrase over a 30-year period has also been added, which simply expresses the duration between the 2 years. So our introduction says the same thing as the topic statement, but in a different way. Let's move ahead to the overview. In the overview, give a general description of the maps and write about the most noticeable differences between the two maps. If you look at the two maps, there are two major changes. One, the hotel has expanded noticeably. It has increased the infrastructure and amenities. Two, the green area has reduced to a great extent. So in the overview, you can make these two general statements about the maps. Here it is. Overall, the hotel has expanded noticeably in the 30-year period by adding three new amenities, a restaurant, a swimming pool, and a children's play area. However, this expansion has also resulted in large-scale reduction of forest cover and agricultural land in the area. If you notice, instead of the word farmland, agricultural land is used. The point is, use as many synonyms as you can to show off your vocabulary range. This could really help boost your score. After the introduction and the overview, it's time to write the two body paragraphs, where we discuss both the maps in detail. Let's first look at body paragraph 1, where you describe the first map in detail. Since the map is of the year 1990, we'll use the simple past tense to describe it. All you have to do is simply describe the location of each place on the map. What was located where? That's all. For instance, if we look at the farmland, to its west, there was a residential area, and to its south, there was a forest. And beside the forest, there was a parking area. Just like this, you have to describe the entire map. So it goes something like this. In 1990, the hotel was built next to farmland, close to a single-lane main road. To the west of the farmland, there was a residential area, which included a few houses. And to the south was a vast woodland, which is a synonym for forest. The hotel also built a car parking area alongside the forest land. Not that difficult, right? Just focus on describing the location of each place on the map. Now let's move on to body paragraph 2, where you describe the second map in detail. Since the second map is of the present year, we'll be using the present tense. More specifically, present perfect tense. Here you have to describe all the changes that have taken place till today. Remember the list we made? It'll come handy here. So here's your second body paragraph. By now, 2020, the hotel has extended dramatically. It has cleared most of the forest to increase the parking area. Also, a part of the forest has been supplanted, meaning replaced, by a swimming pool and a play area for children. Furthermore, the farmland has been reduced to half in order to make way for a small restaurant. Besides, the main road has also been widened to a double lane road. You can see all the changes have been described really well. With this, our map description is complete, and here is the full response. It's over 150 words, which is the minimum word limit. Now let me take you through four important points or parameters that you need to keep in mind to score high in the map task. Number one, cover all the parts of the question, which is also known as task achievement. The examiner expects you to write a clear introduction, an overview, and description of the specific features of the maps, just like this sample answer does. Do what they expect, cover all the parts, and you'll get a higher score in the task achievement category. Number two, write a well-structured and logical response, which is also known as coherence and cohesion. The examiner expects you to write a response which is well-organized and understandable. If we look at the model answer, it has been structured well using paragraphs, and it has a clear progression as the topic is first introduced, then the general features are identified, and further it clearly compares the first map with the second. This is why using an outline is so important. It gives your writing a natural and logical flow. Also, linking words such as overall, however, furthermore, besides, have also been used to connect different ideas. Paragraphing, linking words, and following a proper outline help you in writing a well-structured and logical response. Our next point is use a wide range of appropriate vocabulary. You'll need to use specific vocabulary in the map task to express where the things were positioned in the past and how things have changed or remain the same presently. In body paragraph 1, Notice the words next to, close to the west, alongside. All these words and phrases help in describing the locations of things on the map in 1990. As body paragraph 2 describes changes, so change specific vocabulary has been used. Hotel has extended, cleared forest to increase parking area, supplanted a swimming pool and a play area, farmland has been reduced to half, road has been widened. All these words represent change. So I would say start familiarizing yourself with such location and change specific vocabulary to get a higher band score. Plus, make sure you use a wide range of words. Don't use the same words repeatedly. And finally, use a wide range of grammatical structures correctly, because the examiner looks at your grammatical range and how accurately you've used grammar while writing your response. For the map task, you need to pay special attention to tenses as well as active and passive voice. The farmland has been reduced to half. The main road has also been widened. That's written in passive form because we don't know who reduced the farmland or who widened the road, right? Along with this, you should use a mix of simple, compound and complex sentences. The more you are able to use complex grammatical structures, the better your score will be, of course, if they are accurate. So keep these four things in mind and you'll definitely score high in the map task. So that's all for today's video. I really hope you understood this map task lesson. And in case you're preparing for IELTS and need any further assistance, feel free to visit our website, unolearning.com. Take a look at our courses, book the one you like and kickstart your IELTS preparation with one of our expert trainers from the comfort of your home. I'll see you in the next video. Goodbye.